So good morning to you guys in the UK, around the world, you UN establishment, intelligence services all over the world, and intelligent, non-corrupted, yeah, researchers, sociology, human behavioral science studiers, yeah, who watch the internet streams, internet discussions, internet seminars, conferences, yeah, and communicate all over the world with like-minded researchers, sociologists, human behavioural scientists and mental health workers. Right, because what I am exposing in Coventry City, West Midlands, UK, yeah, is a gang of covert operators, local people, mercenaries, police officers who are making videos of their targets after setting up Big Brother using see-through wall technology, outlining equipment, yeah, linked to sonar, radar, yeah, NHS linked equipment, linked to audiology, taking photographs of people's eyes. Yeah, being obsessed with it. And where audiology has been confirmed, it has no trustworthy researching information. Yeah, everything they capture, yeah, is not trustworthy. And it has no accuracy to determine whether anyone's ill or got a physical pain. Yeah, because it could be just hay fever. It could be a chlorine from swimming pools. Yeah, it could be that the glare of the sun or computer monitor or a phone. Yeah, laptop. Yeah, it could be poor eyes, poor lights, yeah, something in your eye, a fly in your eye, dust in your eye, yeah, or if you're going out drinking alcohol, it could be starry-eyed, sparkly-eyed, yeah, or if you're going to your funeral, yeah, your eyes will be stressed, your eyes will be watery, bloodshot, due to mourning a loved person that you've gone to the funeral of, or it could be tears of joy, yeah, but these audiology desperados in Coventry who have corrupted audiology, yeah, social engineer audiology to misdiagnose their targets with, yeah, to tell stories about it all to judging jurors, to mental health administrators, yeah, to stitch and frame people up they've done audiology on, yeah, OTT audiology on, illegal audiology on, yeah, criminal practicing audiology on, yeah, let alone all the human body locks those that they're doing to people, yeah, and because they set up Big Brother on people, they're using this technology, thermology, infrared, ultrasound, x-ray, yeah, looking into people's homes, looking, winding their targets up so they can make the videos interesting, make the profiles interesting, make the internet streams interesting, and make the future portfolios, dossiers, and whatever they've captured of a target and their family, if a family is involved, yeah, and they try and tell their own TV show, own story to it all. But judging jurors know, worldwide people know, yeah, logical thinking people know, yeah, there's two different sides to the story, yeah, a photograph tells 100 stories, yeah, and it's the same with video, whoever is narrating, yeah, to the presentation, yeah, and so I'm letting everyone know, yeah, that not in Coventry as well, but in the West Midlands, where these people are networking me to, yeah, West Midlands linked NHS mental health sectors in Nuneaton, in Bedworth, in Rugby, Northampton, Leamington, yeah, Northampton, yeah, London, and Birmingham, yeah, there's a gang who criminal practice together, who communicate together to find out what's going on in the local area about anyone they are subjecting, abusing, yeah, in the similar strategies. Yeah, linked to stalking people. Yeah, so, yeah, this is happening around the UK due to these big mouths who were stalking me, my mother, my brother, yeah, giving the secrets away. Yeah, because they're amateurs, they're incompetent, and they're learning, training, yeah? So, yeah, they're messing up quite a lot of times, and that's why I've spotted overt and covert operators and heard the equipment and heard the covert operators every now and then talking amongst themselves when they're illegally capturing me, my mother and my brother together in our family's home, or when they're stalking me on my own anywhere where I've been for the last 16 years. Yeah, and so, because there's two different sides to the story, anything they've said about me is a compulsive lie. Yeah? Because, yeah? Because the judging jurors have not heard my version yet. Yeah? So that's what I have to put onto social media to warn judging jurors. Yeah? The picture tells hundreds of stories. Depends who's telling it. Yeah? That's going to try and convince, manipulate, defraud, commit perjury, contempt of court. Yeah? In the family courts of protection, where only the cover operators and sector workers are allowed to tell their version of the story of their trying to portray the targets as, because the targets and their solicitors, yeah, they're not allowed in these courtrooms, yeah, and that's where they get court orders on their targets, because the target can't defend themselves. That's why the family court of protection has to be abolished. Yeah, UK government, yeah, parliament, yeah, to the House of Commons, yeah, you need to abolish these family court or protection, yeah, courts, yeah, because rogue social workers, rogue mental health administrators, rogue police officers, rogue private detective agencies, yeah, use this family court of protection to destroy people like me, yeah, because, yeah, they don't want people like me to tell our version of the stories, because it's the truth, yeah, especially when we expose it all on social media, yeah, about what they have been getting away with for decades and generations in those historical misdiagnosing, detaining cases via family court protections, getting court orders on people, yeah, to destroy their lives. Yeah, that's what we did to Ian Harden and Ellis Trigger. They misdiagnosed him after the self-surveillance, the same way they did on me, my mother and my brother. Yeah, that was the elder dormant generation and the people who they associate with, yeah, back in the late 1980s. Since then, some of these people have been protected, yeah, by the council and been social engineered to be plastic wannabes, yeah, and community leaders. Yeah, yeah, while their gang has been entrenched by the police force and by the council. Yeah, so they're all protected and walk around with the plastic wannabes. Yeah, and so saga continues today. Yeah, that's how lies about me eating. That's how lies about me sleeping. That's how lies about me walking. Communicating, yeah, it's like a two sides of a different story. What we've captured on me and my mother, yeah, having family domestics, yeah, they'll lie and say the family can't communicate with each other, there's something going on, that's why we keep coming back to them, yeah. But reality is, yeah, they're there to social engineer, yeah. Anytime we've argued, it's been me talking, trying to explain about cover operators abusing the family, yeah, about whether they're using neighbours, whether they're hiding in houses nearby, yeah, capturing all our communications, yeah, and so that's what where it gets heated, because my mother can't understand it, my brother doesn't believe it, thinks like what the email was sent, the police force sent to me, the police ain't got the resources and the manpower, yeah, to waste their time on people like us, yeah, so my brother, yeah, and so that's what the arguments have been over. Yeah, whatever they showed to sector workers, yeah, whatever they showed to judging jurors, whatever they're shown on websites, and whatever they're going to show in the future, whether it's Tony Chapman, Roy Lewis, or the young smokers, or the young researchers, yeah, shown around the world, yeah, they're compulsive liars. Yeah, so that's all, no one can trust them, whether they're shown it to all over the world, on the websites, or for family court protection. Yeah, it's two different sides to the story. Yeah, you just can't believe the people who are narrating to it. Yeah, you can't believe, yeah, these degenerated idiots. Yeah, Tony Chapman, Ryan Lewis, Ashley Mapp, Nathan Crane, Michael Hara, to the boys and girls who worked at SES. Yeah, Steve Baney's, Marvin Davis's, Matthew Lee, Scott Lee, Martin Lee. Yeah, to the Briscoes, to the Duncan Thurbys, to the Brian Goodens. Yeah, yeah, to the Dorm Association, Dave Leveridge and Carl Keeble, who show me and my family to villages all over the UK. Yeah, to military, to Navy, yeah, bumpkins they associate with, yeah, because these people think they're ahead of everyone because they've got government equipment, yeah, and suddenly so they think they're intelligent. Oh, don't tell the local people, yeah, just, yeah, and so, yeah, that's how shot away the ego's gone, yeah, because they use all these technologies, yeah, they seem to think they're better than everyone. So if everyone knows who's got these technologies, everyone knows who this gang is, yeah, yeah. We have to put law to it all to make sure they abolish these technologies and get rid of it all. Yeah? Otherwise, the people are not going to tolerate it. Yeah, thermology, infrared, ultrasound, x-ray, see-through technology, at-home technology, spying on people's homes. Yeah, no one, yeah, can tolerate that behaviour in Coventry or anywhere in the UK or in the world. That's what TRs are exposing it all. Yeah, so that these people get rounded up. They've got nowhere to hide. Yeah, because if they've showed it to too many people, yeah, it's all going to come back on them. And so, Coventry people, teenagers, school children, families, yeah, who will not tolerate this, stand up against them. Yeah, there's more of us than there is of them. Yeah, they're only a small gang. They're a small minority. Yeah, they have to be rooted out of Coventry doing this evil, yeah, school duggery on the, in the neighbourhood of Coventry, yeah, and then networking it to all the boys and girls, like-minded girls and boys into voyeurism, yeah, around the UK, around the local cities and villages, yeah, and so that's all they have to be exposed. And so the saga continues, yeah, they just doing the same as yesterday, yeah, capturing me from all different sides, yeah, obsessed in human body language, obsessed in the way people are sleeping, yeah, people are waking up, obsessed in the way people sit on toilets, going to the toilets, the way they're wiping, the wiping their bottoms afterwards, yeah, obsessed in the way people's shoulders look to their boyfriends, to their girlfriends, obsessed in how people's stomachs look, comparing it to their boyfriends and girlfriends, obsessed in the way people go about their lives, comparing it to their criminal practicing boyfriends and girlfriends who love a bit of corruption, love ducking and diving, love breaking the law, yeah? Because, yeah, they're trying to put pressure on targets, trying to break targets down, trying to get reactions at targets, hoping targets go mentally insane and start running out accusing the neighbours or go around looking for people. Yeah, this is what we're trying to ramp up. Yeah, yeah, and that's how the pressure they're trying to put on me. Yeah, if I was still sitting there all day, coming out of all with all local people's names who were racketeer. Yeah, and then thinking that I'm going to go looking for them, or thinking I'm going to jump on YouTube, stop effing and blinding, going berserk. Yeah, and then slipping up, whatever. Yeah, it's called entrapment. Yeah, entrapment every day via psyops. Yeah, via psychological warfare operating. Yeah, going out equipped. Overt and covert operators, yeah, that's why they have to be arrested, yeah, because they're just trying to get their own story across, yeah, hoping, yeah, family court protection, which is closed, to put to their targets, to defend themselves, like normal open courts of law, yeah, they're just hoping they can tell their own version of what they've captured, yeah, of what they've videoed, or what they've sound recorded, yeah, and edit it all into damning personal persecution, yeah, to try and frame, stitch, detain, listed targets that they won't give up on, targets who are exposing them, been exposing them for many, 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 many years, yeah, and they're up against it, but they won't walk away, yeah, because the COVID team leader, his head's, he or she, their head's erupted like a volcano, yeah, and they're racing 100 miles an hour, all kinds of twisted thoughts and thinking processes, thinking, how can I destroy this family? How can I stitch him up? Yeah, secondly, because they're stalking my mother, yeah, everyone needs to look at these stalkers, these video makers, these network bloggers, yeah, linked to the local people, yeah, who are getting access to it all, yeah, yeah, they're trying to rob her, yeah, they're trying to put fear into a pensioner, so Coventry people, they can't tolerate it, yeah, because they hang around her fraudsters, yeah, they're hoping, yeah, she may be tired, yeah, over pressured to leave a handbag lying around, yeah, so they can go stealing the handbag off her. Yeah, and stealing credit cards off that. Yeah, that's why I've named the fraudsters. Yeah, but yeah, yeah, these fraudsters have got no morals. Yeah, they'll steal off their mothers and fathers. They'll steal off pensioners. Yeah, they'll steal anything and locked down in the works area. Yeah, and that's why I'm trying to expose their gang. Yeah, so by association, they're all going to get arrested. They're all going to get imprisoned because it's a major conspiracy. Yeah, with over 100, 200, 300 people. Yeah, because that's how long it's escalated to. More than that, yeah, when you use the internet, when you use the over and covert operators, yeah, count the volunteers who they know in the UK County Lines network who they can contact to say, oh, we've got someone passing through your city today, through your town, through your village. Can you get some people to gang to set up some surveillance in around the area so that we can keep the network going? Yeah, and so, yeah, that's what rogue, corrupted police officers, yeah, get up to, yeah, when they're doing this kind of training, experimenting, yeah, targeting, surveillance, monitoring campaigns, because campaigns, yeah, last, yeah, will carry on after a couple of weeks, yeah, running into months, running into yours, as TR's exposing worldwide. Yeah, and so, yeah, everybody, that's enough information there. I hope to do short videos, but for time with me, as TR's know, these are surveillance monitoring campaigns, targeting programs that we talk about. Yeah, you can talk about them all day long. Yeah, because there's that many sub-projects, that many different strategies, techniques, yeah, that are interesting to talk about. And you can talk about it, yeah, in conferences and seminars, yeah, if you're good at communicating. Yeah, and you can be there for hours. Yeah, just talking about just one aspect of it all, about the, say, about the MK Ultra Control programming. Yeah, that's a whole day's worth. Yeah, more weeks worth. Yeah, of just talking about psychological warfare programs and what they can do to different people. Yeah, from babies in women's wombs, yeah, to the two children growing up, to teenagers. Yeah, they can, yeah, psychologically damage, psychologically control someone, yeah, with all these, yeah, government psychological warfare, psychiatric, psychoanalyzing, yeah, mind-controlling programs, if people are not aware of it all. Yeah, that's why we are. Yeah, that's why I'm letting people, conscious people know. Yeah, these programs are a danger to society. Yeah, they can control boys and girls from a young age and use them anywhere they want, whether it be drug dealers, yeah, drug mules, yeah, escort prostitution, yeah, escorts, yeah, turn them into rent boys, turn them into prostitutes, call girls. Yeah, turn them into plastic gangsters, moles, plastic criminal wannabes. Yeah, wannabe criminals. Yeah, yeah. They can train them to work for the gang for decades and generations. Yeah, they can brainwash them. Yeah, to steal information from government, council, or private organisations they work for, to pass information on to the gangs or to rival corporations, to rival gangs, rival councils. Yeah. And so that's what I mean. Remember, that's all spun off from MK Ultra Control, from the CIA, FBI, Operation Paperclip, yeah, and the mind control experiments they were doing back in the 50s, 60s, and 70s. Yeah, hundreds of them out there. Yeah, so that's just a subject in itself. So that's why TRs are putting these videos out there, yeah, showing their experiences to the survivors out there who stayed mentally strong enough. Yeah, and putting these programs together, or putting the experiences together, to warn people in all over the world, yeah, that governments are doing this, local councils are doing this, and we're using corrupted local people in the know, yeah, protected list of peace informers, yeah, or volunteers, yeah, who are aiding and abetting, yeah, the corrupted, rogue government workers and local council workers. Yeah, and so, yeah, and then so if people are not aware of these programs, yeah, yeah, you'll never know whether your conscious, subconscious mind is being messed around with, yeah, and being preyed on, yeah, being targeted, yeah, and because of neuroscience, neuro-linguistics, nanotechnology, frequency technology, yeah, it can all open up various occupations and various researching sub-projects, yeah, into all kinds of researching targeting protocols, yeah, and so that's why, these crimes are happening all over the world, yeah, because linked to biometrics, linked to neuroscience, yeah, so yeah, and also obviously linked to AI, yeah, technologies, yeah, linked to the NHS industry, because obviously they can train, yeah, students, college kids, and future juniors, yeah, in the colleges, universities, seminars, Zoom conferences, yeah, or in their own campus on site. Yeah, with what they capture of targeted individuals. Yeah, telling their own version of stories. Yeah, and so that's why, yeah, again, TIs are exposing worldwide. Yeah, these crimes have to stop. Yeah, and we can't let these universities, colleges, yeah, these NHS, these mental health administrators, future ones, yeah, to the retired ones who come out of retirement all excited about all this new technology, wishing they were young again. Yeah, you can't let these psychiatrists, sociologists, even behavioral scientists, yeah, get away with these crimes, yeah? Because they are paying, yeah? The local criminals, nationwide criminals. They're paying mercenaries, yeah, to go out and abuse people, yeah? So that's where all the minutes come from. Yeah, that's what I've worked out to TIs. Yeah, some of yous will think differently. And again, the program is different and unique to TIs all over the world. Yeah, some of it's just probably just done by the police force. So those will be twisted, those will be nasty. Yeah, and it won't be as scientific, as medical, as clinical, as what they've done to me. Depends where I'm coming from. Yeah, and so everybody, more information to understand the targeting, stalking, illegal surveillance monitoring, right, ever spent campaigns for doing people, yeah, because in the name of science, in the name of careers, yeah, people will do anything. That means breaking all laws going, yeah, chasing their dream. But everybody, have a good day. Everyone out.